Welcome to All-Star Championship Wrestling, an hour of excitement with the biggest names in professional wrestling. And now, here's your ringside commentator.
Welcome to Championship Wrestling, fans. We have a great lineup of matches today planned for you and interviews. So stay tuned. We'll be back with Championship Wrestling. This match is a one-fall, 10-minute time limit. Managed by beautiful Saul Creatchman, seconded by his partner Wild Hogg, at 283, King Harley Hogg. His opponent at 218, from Mexico City, Juan Zapata. Welcome to Championship Wrestling today, fans. What a treat. Other than this opening bout featuring one of the Hogs, that is King Harley Hogg and Juan Zapata, we have as special guest none other than WFBQ personality, air personality from Indianapolis, Indiana, none other than Bob and Tom. Welcome.
Thanks, Dave. It looks like we're going to have an exciting match here.
Bob, this is the first time you've ever seen professional wrestling live.
Live. I've seen it on TV many times, but never live. And it's more enjoyable live than it is on television.
Tom, you're here this evening. What do you think of seeing the matches live? You've been here once before, but never this close.
Never this close indeed, Dave. This is great. Last time I was here, I saw the great Bobo Brazil. I saw Dick the Bruiser. I'm looking forward to this match very much. It's incredible being this close.
And sitting along with Bob and Tom from WFBQ, none other than the Reverend. Welcome.
Good evening, Dave. We're looking forward to a great night here. Been a Bruiser buddy for some time now.
The Reverend, a Bruiser buddy, and you're going to possibly see all Bruiser's friends. One in particular on today's telecast, fans, you're going to see none other than Yukon Moose Cholak. We have an hour of excitement planned for you. I'm your host, David McClane, and in the ring, King Harley Hogg jamming on, if you will, Juan Zapata. And Hogg having the upper edge in not only experience, but weight. As you'll note, Bob, the Hogg seems to be a bit patched up.
Yes, indeed. I noticed he's got a bandage across his forehead, and he seems to outweigh this man quite a bit.
Earlier in today's matches that were filmed here, fans, the Hogs took on none other than Bobo Brazil and Bobby Colt, a devastating bout in which controversy surrounds. But the men that left the ring with the mask, if you will, of red, the sea of red, which is trying to be opened up by Zapata, were the Hogs. A drop kick by Zapata. Hogg seems dazed, Tom.
Yeah, when we came in, he was bleeding, and they've opened up that cut again. There's blood all over his luscious blonde hair. He's hurting now.
The Hogg in trouble. Zapata showing what it's about, opening up. Hogg delivering those boots, those kicks, and it seems to be a chokehold.
Sure does.
Hogg, fans, has on the outside none other than Saul Creatchman and Wild Hogg. Saul Creatchman is noted. He wants no part of the Reverend, Bob, or Tom. In fact, he doesn't even like their radio station. Saul Creatchman, I believe what he listens to, Bob and Tom, is the Hogs in the morning grunting and sounding off rather than any music.
Oh, his wound has really opened something horrible. Oh, man.
He feels no pain, though. He feels no pain. He's got an open wound, but look at him go.
Hogg on the delivery. Oh, a big body slam. Reverend, how would you like to be the recipient of that?
Oh, my goodness. I'd need some heavy healing after that.
The referee in this opening bout, fans, is none other than Billy Beach. It's a chokehold once again. Hogg not fazed by the seeping of blood. And as so far, he has had no assistance from Saul Creatchman or Wild Hogg. Look at the size of this hog, Bob, as he's coming toward us.
Amazing.
Unbelievable. Is the guy big or what?
He's gigantic.
So the words of Hogg, Wild Hogg. Oh, he's just running right behind him, possibly pulling up on that throat. Hogg is possibly choking him. Beach is there to see. He's telling him to break. Hogg not doing so could be cause for automatic disqualification. But Hogg breaks in time into the ropes. Zapata goes. Another body slam. Watch this, Bob and Tom, up to the second rope. And it's coming off of him, Bob. Oh, elbow smash all the way. Check it out. One, two, three. And it's lights out, baby, for Zapata. The winner, King Harley Hogg. Fans, you stay tuned. We're going to be back after these messages, interviews, upcoming news. And then you're going to see in action a strap match, Chris Carter and Dr. Jerry Graham. Fans, Championship Wrestling returns next Saturday night, February 23rd, 8 p.m., Northside 10 Alarm Ring 2 title matches, and it's the annual Leukemia Fighters Night, fans, in honor of Yorktown's Bobby Remington. Fans, it's going to be a spectacular Saturday, February 23rd, 8 p.m., a night to remember. The main event, you're going to see a street fight match in which the wrestlers, Moose, Bruiser, and the Warriors, Supermax and Mad Max, enter the ring fully clothed, and it won't be on television. And they will be stripped down to their wrestling tights. The ones that are unclothed first are the losers. Fans, it's a fight to the finish, and it's a match in which they come in clothed and are torn and shredded. Fans, it will not be on television. Also, fans, you're going to see on there none other than Stormy, Granzig, and Lawler versus Wild Hogg and King Harley Hogg. It's the tag team title match that Granzig would like to win due to the fact he would like to have a belt around his waist once again. Also on the card, fans, you're going to see Bobby Colt, managed by Bobo, in there against Wojo, managed by Dr. Jerry Graham. It's a title match. Wojo, the champion, versus the international playboy, Bobby Colt. It's a match Colt's been looking forward to for some time. Also on the card, fans, it's an all-star card. Chris Carter versus the Hangman. Also on the card, you're going to see in action Dr. Jerry Graham and Bulldog Don Kent versus Bobo Brazil and Van Camp. It's tag team action you won't want to miss. Also on the card, fans, you'll see Candy Devine versus Amy Luce. And word has it that Princess Jasmine will be there instead of Amy Luce. That's the word that's out. We'll find out next Saturday night. Devine could be in there against her enemy, Princess Jasmine. Also, Calypso Jim will be there, the Animal, Saul, Mr. T, Tom Lynch. Also on the card, four all-star matches. It's all coming your way, fans, and it's coming next Saturday night. Tickets are available throughout the week at all Ticketmaster locations, Blocks Department Store, MSA Box Office, and they'll be available at the Northside 10 Alarmory after 1 p.m. the day of the show. We'll see you next Saturday night. No disqualification. You agreed to it, Dr. Graham. No disqualification. Strap match. From New York, New York, at 2:35, the toast of the East Coast, the self-proclaimed world's most educated wrestling manager, Dr. Jerry Graham. His opponent from Detroit, Michigan, at 2:38, Chris Carter. This is it, fans, a leather strap match. They're tied wrist to wrist. The referee, the Dean, Connie Marker, next to me. The men that are Dr. Jerry Graham's proteges, none other than one, the heavyweight champion of the world, the great Wojo, and also Bulldog Don Kent.
And let me tell you, I don't think enough proper respect's been paid to the Bulldog here. This is one of the greatest wrestlers the world has ever known.
United States Tag Team Champion.
Tremendous wrestler, also one of my mentors. He's been a tremendous coach for me. He deserves some credit.
Bulldog, this is it. You're here at ringside, both of you just watching the action.
Well, I think it's going to be a one tough match, but I think for one thing... Hey, break that up! You're choking him here!
There's a no disqualification clause, Bulldog! No disqualification, Bulldog!
Yeah, I'm sure the doctor's going to get out of this and come out the true champion it is. Look at that body on the man.
Carter tagging number two. Here's three. That's the object of the match. No submission, no pinfall. You must tag consecutively all four turnbuckles. Wojo, you oppose the no disqualification clause.
Oh, absolutely right. I mean, you know, you can't take chances. A great man like Dr. Graham. The man's tremendous. You can't take a chance on an injury here.
Really. Do you think without Graham that your style would be hampered?
I need the doctor. I mean, the doctor's my mentor. He's my coach. He's a tremendous man. You're looking at the three greatest. I'm Wojo the Great, but I wouldn't be great without guys like Dr. Jerry Graham Jr. and Don Kent.
Bulldog Don Kent cheering on Dr. Jerry Graham. There's one. There's two. He's making it look easy, Bulldog.
Come on. Thing. You know, the great Wojo, Olympic champion, NCAA champion, 13 times AAU champion, and just how much more of a wrestler can you get? And a great man.
Well, Wojo, no doubt, is a gentleman. The only lacking quality many claim is that you hang around Dr. Jerry Graham.
Well, Mr. Kent is exactly right. I am a great man. I am a great wrestler. Dr. Jerry Graham Jr. is the man that has made me great, and I'll never forget that. I owe everything to that man. He saved my career.
Outside, and now Graham pulling him back. Using the advantage of this match of having that leather rope. And he's pulling him in. Jamming him now at the knee. Another knee. Another.
I wish the fans here would treat these guys, Bulldog Don Kent, Dr. Jerry Graham Jr., proper respect. That's all we want.
Well,
proper respect.
Also, if you don't appreciate the barking when the Bulldog comes to ringside.
I can't stand that. I don't want to hear that when I'm in the arena because it bothers Mr. Kent. And people shouldn't bother a great man like that. He needs his concentration.
There's three, and Carter pulls him back. This is a grudge match. Graham continually was running from Carter. Each opportunity Carter had, he was unable to seize.
He was not running. What are you talking about? He's just trying to run.
That's why we have the
Dirty tactics by Carter.
Watch him out. Carter pushing Graham back. There's two. Three.
Yeah, there we go.
Both men have almost had a victory, but not yet.
Hey, nobody's going to beat the doctor. Look at that. Look at that. Look at the strength of that man. Look at that physique. Look at the muscles ripple. Tremendous. That's where Carter belongs. He doesn't belong in the same ring with the doctor.
They're choking him.
Yeah, it's all over. It's over now. I'm going to tell you one thing. You've never seen a smarter man in that ring than a good doctor. You've never seen a man that used more tactics because it's thoroughly brain work out there now. This, without a doubt, the smartest man in professional wrestling today. And I say this in sincerity, because I have never seen a man that has the wits and the know-how that Dr. Jerry Graham Jr. has tonight.
An Eastern prep education. Graham's had it all. He has the glory. He has Bulldog Don Kent and Wojo right here cheering him on. The only ones in the packed house today. There isn't a ringside seat available. They've all been sold out to see this bout. They want to see it, and they're seeing it live in person. What was illegal about it, Wojo?
That knee, he's obviously got something in that knee pad. No doubt about it.
Graham has knee pads.
Carter's got a loaded knee pad.
Now, Dean, Mr. Marker checked both men. You're saying he put something in it within the match?
Had to be an illegal. He had somebody, a fan, give it to him or something, because Dr. Graham would not crumble like that from just a knee.
Fabricated. That's what it is. Fabricated, fans. Wojo fabricating.
The man has courage. Look at that. Look at him come back from there. Now you'll see some scientific wrestling here. Here's where those four doctorate degrees will pay off.
He's choking the man.
That's leverage. He's got a jaw hold on him. He's going against a pressure point that he so studied so well in college.
Graham hasn't been able to run. The match is effective.
Well, now the Graham's effective. Look at that. Look at that. Tremendous. What can I say? Oh!
He uses that rope effectively.
It's all leverage. That's part of the strap match. Beautiful use of this strap.
Graham almost tagging the fourth rope. If he tags that fourth rope, it's all over for Chris Carter. He's still almost within the meet. Dr. Jerry Graham. The winner is Graham. But Bulldog Don Kent, you had a hand in it. You pulled Carter
good all the time. I knew it because the man is without doubt the smartest man that there is in wrestling today, and he just proved why.
That was a fantastic display of scientific knowledge. He used his strap perfectly.
Graham is being beaten. Bulldog coming into the ring, jamming on Carter. Graham has been beaten. Here comes Wojo into the ring now. Something's going to have to be done here. Wojo and Bulldog, although I commend them for not interfering. Here comes Stormy Granzig. Stormy Granzig coming in. And he's jamming on Wojo. He's got the Bulldog. Graham exits. Stormy Granzig comes to the aid of his friend, Chris Carter. Coming to the aid of his friend, Stormy Granzig. What about this? What about coming to the aid? None other than Stormy. Stormy, welcome back. You've been out of wrestling for some time with this broken arm. And now you're back and you look better than ever.
I'm glad to be back in WWA. It's a great organization, and it's just not right. And I felt Chris being a friend of mine, I had to come out here if I could.
Chris, you almost had it, partner.
Hey, David.
And Graham pulled it out of nowhere.
I tell you, I've had it. If it's not two, now it's three. You know, you need
Stormy
a man
Granzig
like Stormy in your corner.
He's
one of my best friends, Dave. And in this business, that's a rare commodity. Because you can't trust anybody. Stormy, I want to welcome you back, hope you're healed up, and tell you, brother, I love you from the bottom of my heart, just like the rest of the people in the WWA, baby.
Thank you for being on. What a match it was, Stormy. Thanks for coming in. Fans, let's go to the formal introductions. It's the Animal in there, making his first appearance in the WWA. This match is a one-fall, 10-minute time limit. from parts unknown at 281, the Animal. His opponent from Detroit, Michigan at 230, Brian Costello. Stormy Granzig coming in to save his pal, Chris Carter. And now we're underway with a new match. And next to me, personality from the morning show of WFBQ, Bob and Tom in the Reverend. Tom, it was a good thing Stormy came in when he did.
I know, I was afraid I was going to get stomped on just sitting here. Stormy came in and saved the day. I'm a little worried about this match. These guys may come right over these ropes and hit us right in the face.
The Animal, a big man, a powerful one, residing where do anyone such as the Animal reside? In the zoo, possibly?
Not near me, Dave. I'm glad to say I don't know where this guy's from. I just want to keep him away from me. He's an animal.
He's not a part of the Q Zoo.
No, he's too big for us. There he's coming closer, Dave. I'm a little worried here.
Reverend, I thought you brought him with you.
No, I didn't bring him with me. My gosh, he's a big fella.
Sweaty, too.
The Animal fans being manhandled by Brian Costello, possibly, because he's pulling the beard of the Animal. Disdain the Animal. Check out that look. Check out that eye.
I had to put my hat on, Dave. The sweat coming off these wrestlers is dripping on me, and I'm all dressed for a wedding here. It's incredible.
You can tell he's just like an animal. He's wild. He looks crazy, but Costello's ring-wise, he looks like he's ready for action. He knows what's going on. He knows how to do it.
The Animal hasn't had much wrestling experience. That's observance of the Reverend. He's been at a truck stop. He's been driving the trucks across America. And that's where he said he learned to be tough. Stopping over at night, having to protect his truck from being stolen. The goods inside, the rig, the Animal with a big backdrop. Check him out, fans. Costello eating up the punishment at the moment. A slap sends Costello across the third rope. A kick, another boot to the belly, another to the chest, and another. A series of boots, and the Animal loves every moment of it. He loves to dish it out, Tom.
Does the Animal speak English? Do we know that much? It's incredible. The man is such an animal.
Possibly, but no doubt he's grunting right now. The bear hug. It could be lights out, Reverend.
I don't know, though. Costello looks like he's coming back. He's fighting pretty hard.
That's it. It's it. Costello submits the winner of the match, the Animal. The Animal. Get a close-up on that man, the Animal. Fans, we'll be back in a moment after these messages and interviews with a super match featuring the big 6'10" hooded Hangman and then Yukon Moose, Cholak, and Stormy Granzig.
8 p.m. North Side, Tyndall Armory, and fans, I'm here with my fighter, and you're going to join him. It's the annual Leukemia Fighters Night, and it's two title matches. It's in honor of Yorktown's Bobby Remington, who passed away some time ago, fans. It's in honor of Bobby that we're putting this on next Saturday night, February 23rd. We want all of you to come out and not only see the matches, but support Leukemia, fans. With your help, we can beat this dreadful disease. And this man, our fighter, will be on hand with everyone, included Dick the Bruiser, the number one fighter of all. And we'll be there next Saturday night, February 23rd, 8 p.m., Northside Tyndall Armory, fans. The main event. There's two title matches on hand. It's a street fight to the finish. The wrestlers come in fully clothed, and fans, Dick the Bruiser and Yukon Moose. Moose will be in his big $300 overhauls, fans. That's how much it costs to fill that man. And Dick and the Warriors will be there fully clothed. Also, the ones that are unclothed first will be the losers. It's a fight to the finish, and it will not be seen on television. Also on the card, fans, you're going to see in action Granzig and Lawler versus the champions for the tag team belts, King Hogg and Wild Hogg, managed by Saul Creatchman. Also on the card, fans, you're going to see Bobby Colt in there against the great Wojo in a singles heavyweight championship bout. Wojo, still the champion. Colt, the man on the search. Also, fans, you'll see an all-star card featuring Carter, the Hangman. Also on the card, Dr. Graham, Bulldog Kent, Van Camp, Bobo Brazil. Also there, you'll see Divine versus what I believe, not Amy Luce, but the lovely Princess Jasmine. She's hoping to make a return and go in there against her enemy, Candy Divine. Also on the card, fans, you'll see Calypso Jim, the Animal, Saul, Mr. T. Lynch, and four all-star matches rounding out the card. And don't forget, Championship Wrestling may be seen next Thursday night, February 21st, 8 p.m., Muncie Lions Club building, Dick the Bruiser and Moose in a lumberjack match in the Muncie, Delaware County Lions building. Also, fans, you're going to see Championship Wrestling returning to Brazil, Indiana, the Brazil National Guard Army, Thursday, February 28th, 8 p.m., 12-man pole battle royal. Tickets available now in Brazil at Clark's Sporting Goods Store in downtown Brazil. That's Thursday, the 28th of February. Also, fans, you're going to see Championship Wrestling in Terre Haute, Friday, March 1st, 8 p.m., disc jockey Jay Ferguson will be part of a six-man tag team match in which Saul Creatchman will be featured. Tickets available there at the Athletic Department Sporting Goods Store, Honey Creek Mall. Also, fans, Championship Wrestling returning to Marion National Guard Armory. Saturday, March 2nd, 8 p.m., Bruiser and Moose will be there. All-Star Card and Maxx. And fans, tickets available there at Vans Sporting Goods Store. That's Vans, downtown Marion, for Saturday, March 2nd, 8 p.m. Tickets are available there. All seats are ringside. And also, fans, wrestling returns to Newcastle, YMCA, Wednesday, March 6th, 8 p.m., Dick the Bruiser, Colt and the Hogs. Tickets are available now at the Sporting Goods Store there. Same location as always. It's the Newcastle YMCA, and tickets are available also, other than the Sporting Goods Store, at the YMCA upstairs level. Also, fans, Championship Wrestling returning to Anderson National Guard Armory Wednesday, March 7th, 8 p.m. Bruiser, Colt and the Hogs, and All-Star Card. That's the Anderson National Guard Armory fans. Advance sale tickets are available now. Also, fans, Championship Wrestling will be coming to town next Saturday night, Leukemia Fighters Night. You won't want to miss it. And this man will be in there with his hogs, and you have the belts.
I've got a problem that's been irking me for quite a long time. I've got the World Tag Team Champions, the Hogs. I've got the gold, the WWA Tag Team Championship belts. And I've also got a Mercedes. There's one thing that I don't have, and that is a chauffeur. I don't have anybody to wear this hat. Well, let me tell you something right now. Calypso Jim, you are the perfect candidate. Dick the Bruiser, I would have got you, but your head's too big and it's like a mongoloid. So, Calypso Jim, you drive the car. I'll be there laughing my head off, and I will see you all at the North.
Because he came up here, he's really, we got to be careful. We can't say anything.
Guerrero bringing Saul in. The Hangman jamming on Gilbert Guerrero. You know, you guys are in the morning. The Hooded Hangman likes to get up in the morning. He could possibly come over to WFBQ and destroy your station.
We have security guards.
Yes, we do. Yes, we sure do.
The Hooded Hangman.
Look at this guy. He's so big, the guy can't even knock him over.
The match is today being seen via satellite across the Midwest, St. Louis, Chicago. Welcome to all you fans watching up in Toronto today. Also Cleveland, Toledo. We're lucky to have flown in today three personalities, the Reverend Bob and Tom, all air personalities of a radio station in Indianapolis, Indiana, the capital of auto racing. Guerrero has the Hangman on his knees now, fans. And Saul is yelling. He's on the throat, but that's not the case. The Hangman went on his knees, is almost as tall as Guerrero. He puts that weight to an advantage, takes Guerrero back, and puts the forearm to the chest. Oh! In there, full force. The Hangman's a big brute, if you may. He's not as agile as many of the wrestlers, such as El Bracero, but he is powerful. Bob, what do you think of the wardrobe of Saul Creatchman?
That's amazing. Unbelievable.
The color combination.
He scares me just looking at him.
But I want to know, Dave, what do those words mean in Chinese or Japanese? We don't know. It could be some kind of hex thing. I don't know what that means. It could be something obscene even. You don't know.
Mumbo jumbo, I think it is. Mumbo jumbo.
No, Creatchman, it probably is.
Saul Creatchman chewing on that gum. A despicable human being.
I'm sure that it does not mean I love my mother.
Possibly. Coming over now to taunt Bob and Tom.
McClane, don't ever, ever take me lightly. I manage nothing but absolute winners. I'd like to have a match with you.
Again, it.
Creatchman, what do those letters mean in Japanese on your back? What does that mean?
Winner, winner, right there.
Oh, what does that mean in the back? Loser in big letters?
Saul Creatchman challenging Bob or Tom. The Hangman stomping on Guerrero's forehead. Big body slam now, fans. Guerrero taking a punishment today. Guerrero in the ropes, trying to have time to breathe. Creatchman just is antagonizing him. Guerrero dazed, but let's give him credit for hanging in there. The backbreaker. His knee is on him. And there's the count. The winner, the Hooded Hangman. Fans, stay tuned. We're coming back after these messages and interviews with none other than Yukon Moose Cholak and Stormy Granzig.
Range tickets are available at Ticketmaster locations, fans. That's Box Department Store, MSA Box Office, and they'll be available, fans, the day of the show at the Northside Tyndall Armory.
Managed by Saul Creatchman, Super Max and Abdullah. Their opponent, Stormy Granzig and Yukon Moose Cholak. A thunderous roar, Chris. You're going by me to join in on the activity. Moose and Stormy.
David, this has to be one of the most dangerous matches in professional wrestling.
Anything can happen.
Anything can happen, that's right. When you've got all these top professionals out here guarding this ring, David, you're right. Anything can happen. It'll be total mayhem here tonight. I'm just glad to be here.
Chris Carter, what's your comment, Dr. Graham?
What are you talking to trash like Chris Carter for?
Graham backing away from you.
You know, David, this guy makes me sick. I told you earlier, it's not only just one, it's not two, now it's three of them. What's this, a rat pack or something they're calling themselves now? What kind of name is that, David?
You know something, Carter? The rat pack is going to be here long after you're gone. I got to tell you something. I'm an educated man, and I'm not quote.
The action right here on the outside between Graham and Carter. Let's allow him to wrestle. Right now, Super Max has a Stormy Granzig up against the ropes. Bob, the wrestlers are surrounding you.
It's amazing. I can't believe this. Now, if they get thrown out, they get thrown back in by the wrestlers. Is that right, Dave?
That's right. It's a human cage match.
Oh, man.
Right there, that man, Bobo Brazil. Dave, I grew up in Cleveland, Ohio. I know you got a lot of fans in Cleveland. Bobo Brazil, I idolize that man. I want to get a picture with Bobo before I leave tonight.
They pack him in, Tom, to see Bobo in Toledo and Cleveland, also the Dayton O'Hare Arena.
Bobo is the greatest. He's my man. I've got to get a picture with Bobo.
Super Max working on the arm of Stormy, that arm heavily taped, bandaged, and it has pads surrounding it. Reasoning, it was broken by one of the Maxes. Look at the physique, Bob, on Granzig.
He's amazing. What a physical specimen.
The guy's put together like a brick house.
Yes, indeed.
He's on the outside. Now, this is what happens, Bob. Stormy wrestlers that dislike him are pounding on him, taking cheap shots.
There's no way they're going to keep Stormy down in this match.
This is what Stormy and Moose wanted.
That's right. You know, they hurt Moose before. They hurt Stormy's arm. This is the chance to get back at least one of the matches for what happened to him.
Bobby Colt, man, just one of the many wrestlers surrounding the ring. Moose, Moose, Moose. Cheering the Yukon on. Moose, close to 400 pounds. Going outside, and they're throwing him back in. One referee, the Dean on the outside, Billy Beach on the inside. Super Max doesn't want any part of Moose. This is our feature match of the day. Hopefully we can bring all of it to you. If not, we'll leave in the midst of the action. Saul, Creatchman. Oh, they could get a shot of this. They're all ganging up on Saul. El Bracero, Calypso Jim.
Dangerous match. Look at the Moose and Stormy. Stormy, hey, Granzig back. He looks great. Look at him.
Hey, you beat up on Saul.
I love it, David. I'll tell you, every time I get a chance, I'm going to pound him right down to the ground.
It's not much to pick on somebody half your size. Creatchman is half your size. You're a typical bully. If it wasn't for the fact that I'm a Christian gentleman, I'd take you apart myself.
Oh, they're all on the outside. It's a brawl. They're in the stands. Some of the wrestlers are going up the aisle.
I tell you what, he make a hell of a comeback. He's still high holding his arm. Oh, he's doing a pretty good job, Dave.
Stormy's full force.
You know, Dave, Stormy looks great. You know, and in response to what Graham said a few minutes ago about me picking on Creatchman, well, it's all right for him to have three people on me, isn't it, David?
That's right.
Right? And how about Bulldog Don Kent? You know, maybe you people don't know, but this guy goes out of his mind if you bark at him. So whenever you see him in the arena, you bark because he goes nuts. He's nuts anyway.
They want him to bark.
How's everything going down here? We're going to get these guys tonight because we trained awful hard.
You got it, Moot.
You know, these illiterate rantings and ravings of substandard intelligence, I'm sure, is very repulsive to the fans. And Carter picking on little small Creatchman, a man half his size, I'm sure is very deplorable to anybody watching this match.
Either Max, if I can interrupt you, he's trying to break Stormy's other arm.
Good. I hope he does. Stormy deserves it. You know, Wojo broke his arm in the first place.
Look at the power ball of Stormy Granzig. Did it take him up? Can you feel the electricity, Tom?
This is the great, I've never had so much fun. This is the greatest match I've ever seen. It's not over. I can't believe it.
It's a one-hour time limit. Unfortunately, due to TV, it's a curfew time limit, and we have less than 2 minutes remaining in our TV broadcast. Moose has the ball. Abdullah trying to body slam the Moose. An impossible feat.
The irresistible force meets the immovable object here. I don't think he's going to get Moose off his feet.
That's the Reverend. The Reverend brings the Big Max, Super Max, into the ring. Stormy, it's a four-way.
And we did it. We're going to do it again. And we're going to keep on doing it.
You did it, Stormy. You're back, baby. All full force.
Our top German guy right here. Right here, Stormy. It's a privilege to have to tag with Moose. He's the greatest, man. Right.
Fans, that's our telecast for the day. I'm David McClane, signing off for Bob and Tom and the Reverend. I hope to see all of you next week.
Later tonight, after Greg Todd and the Channel 6 News, don't miss Lee Grant as a judge-turned-detective on the Channel 6 Late Movie. Watch Partners in Crime tonight at 11:30, only on 6.